Welcome to Southwest Yard and Garden. I'm Curtis Smith. A few weeks ago, we answered a question about tree rings using this piece of tree right here. George Duda with New Mexico State Forestry explained what these rings will tell us. And we're here again with George to learn more about tree rings. And George, this is from what kind of tree?
That's a green ash.
Green ash. And how old is it?
It's about 110 years old.
And then right next to it, we've got a different tree.
This is a Douglas fir from northern New Mexico.
And it's a little larger?
Mm-hmm.
How old is it?
It's about 220 years old.
Okay, and then you brought us these as well. This
yes.
is ponderosa?
This is a ponderosa pine.
And how old?
About 75 years.
75, and we compare?
To 220.
And so it should be smaller.
Yes.
It's smaller.
Mm-hmm.
But this one now?
Now that's our state tree. That's a pinon pine. Yeah. And the rings were counted under a binocular microscope. The rings are so tight, and I came up with 214.
So it's nearly the age of this one.
That's correct.
And what's the difference?
The environment, the species, water.
This grows where it's dry?
Mm-hmm. This grows where it's moist.
And so it grows much faster.
Yeah, yeah.
So the rings are spaced much wider.
Much wider.
One. A lot easier to count.
Much easier to count.
Let's look at these rings over here. This ash is probably a good one to look at, to see the rings.
Mm-hmm.
How do these rings grow?
Well, there's a spring wood. The wide part there we see is summer wood. And as the summer progresses and it gets drier, we see a darker ring. So rings really are a combination of the two. One ring, one year, is the summer wood, spring wood, and the summer wood.
Okay, so do all trees produce only a single ring?
Not all trees.
Because I've got an oak tree in my front yard that puts on about 3 growth flushes every year.
Mm-hmm.
So I suspect it makes 3 rings a year.
Sure does.
So you have to know the tree if you're going to try and count years using the rings.
And depend on those years. Mm-hmm.
And so in this one, you said it goes back a long time.
110 years, 1890.
But we also, as we talked about in the question and answer segment a few weeks ago, we see the history of New Mexico in here.
Yes. If we look at the outside of the tree, just under the bark, year 2000, and we go back about 20 years, and we see a cluster of rings that are very tight and very small. That represents the drought of the 80s. Going back another 30 rings or so, we come back into the horrible drought of the 50s. It shows up very clearly. We go back another 20 or so years, and here are the Dust Bowl days, a very dry period of time, a horrible time in the West. And going back even further to when the tree was very young, there's a band of very tight rings about 1900. There was a drought in that period of time also.
Interesting. The tree tells a tale.
The trees tell the tale.
And I see it split here.
It's drying.
As wood dries, it splits.
It splits.
And so that's just a natural thing here.
Yes, it
has nothing to do with the rings, though,
no,
does it?
No, it does not.
And this Douglas fir has a split, but that tells us something about this tree.
That's what we call a pitch seam. And the tree, as the tree sways in strong winds, it needs to flex a little bit. So the tree sometimes inside will crack, and pitch forms in this crack and actually acts as a lubricant. So the tree can flex in the wind and survive the 220 years of wind and weather.
And so this one formed mm-hmm. while the tree was still standing.
Yes, it did.
Whereas the one over here on the ash tree formed after it was
drying
cut.
Out. Yes.
Very interesting. And we also see something interesting in this Douglas fir. We've got these marks here and here.
Those are where branches were forming, and where it was cut just happened to cut through those branches. So you can see how the branch was growing in relation to the trunk of the tree, and it disappeared here because it went outside the cut.
Okay, and the trunk grew around the branch.
Around
as
the trunk
got larger and larger, it just included the branch in it.
Exactly.
So we can see that history of the growth of the tree as we look at this section of tree as
That's
well.
That's correct.
But that was also because of a lucky cut.
A lucky cut.
This pinon also tells a story too. It's got something going on right here.
Yes, it's probably an injury, a mechanical injury. And when it happened, the tree is trying to heal itself and cover up that injury. And we see some mast pitch. And the tree is sealing itself off so it can continue growing.
Could have been a broken branch, broken in the wind.
Mm-hmm.
But this kind of thing happens in urban areas.
Sure does.
These trees tell us some very interesting things. Thanks for interpreting what the tree tells us and telling us about the tree rings.
Glad you're here, Curtis. Thank you.